If you are struggling with the subpar camera, stay tuned. I'm going to do a deep dive into the Sony ZV-1 Mark I. Just so that you know, it shoots brilliantly stunning 4K video, as well as exceptionally crisp photos. Is it the ultimate YouTube camera or not? So in this video, I'm going to go through the pros and the cons. I'm going to mix and match them. Firstly, as you know, this camera shoots brilliant 4K. So if you're curious as to what the camera capabilities are like, this is being shot right now at 4K 24 frames per second. What I do like about this camera is that you can control most of the features using your phone or even a laptop or computer if you're on the same Wi-Fi network. Or if you are able to, you can actually get the little tripod stand. One of the cons is that it does come with a 1-inch sensor. Sony worked their magic, and even though it's a smaller sensor, you are able to get far superior photo and video quality. The best part of this camera for me as a vlogger and YouTuber is that it has the tally light up front. So just as you're looking at the lens, a con of this device is that it's quite expensive. If you're interested to know whether the ZV-1 Mark II versus the ZV-1 original, there's not much reason to upgrade other than a wider lens. But enough about the Mark II. Let's focus on the Mark I. Hands down, the best feature of the ZV-1 is the autofocus. If you're like me and you're coming from an older camera, autofocus usually was the biggest issue. What is up, guys? This is a mic test of the built-in audio in the ZV-1. And also to keep in mind that there's no time limit when recording a video. You are only limited by your battery power or your memory card. But the camera itself does not limit your video length. Back to the cons. If you attach the camera itself to a tripod, you cannot access the memory card or the battery. Another con of the device is that it's still micro USB. Now, I know most of you are saying, but Revenge's hammer, that really doesn't matter. Then you're gonna have to go and peek and see which direction to actually plug the micro USB. Another pro, it has a webcam capability. So you simply connect the micro USB to your computer. So, I mean, if you look at this video content right now, it's 4K at 24 frames per second at the highest setting available. A con is that you can't take photos while in video mode. So you have to swap between photo and video mode. Just know that it also has a built-in ND filter. Now, what that means is that in daylight, it will get super bright. Okay, so now more technical specs. Let's start off with the lens. The lens is from 24 mils to 70, so it's a 24 to 70 mils. Right now, it is more or less an arm's length away. That's about 70 centimeters or so, and it's at 24 millimeters. The f-stop, or the lens itself, is 1.8 to 2.8. Now, you only get the f1.8 at the 24 mils. The second you zoom in, it goes to f2.8. In terms of your input-output, at the top you have the microphone capsule, and it comes with that little dead cat that slots into the hot shoe mount. You have a microphone input, you have the micro USB for charging as well as data, and you have the micro HDMI. Now, the good thing about this camera is that it charges with micro USB, so even if you only have one battery and you're running low while shooting, just like this, if you're shooting a YouTube video, you don't need a dummy battery. You can either connect it to a power bank, or you can run it off a power brick connected to the mains. Either way, you can have a continuous power supply without having to change batteries. You only need to change batteries when you're on the field, unless you're willing to use a power bank. The reasons why I recommend this for YouTube, simply put, is because it's practical. Like I said earlier, it's a one-stop shop. It also has product showcase.
Now, the accessories that I recommend for this, especially if it's for a YouTube setup like this, you can either go with a condenser mic or a shotgun mic, a longer micro USB cable. So if your charging brick is at one side of the studio, as well as a larger memory card. Now, because it doesn't shoot 10-bit video, you don't really need a UHS class 3. My final verdict as to whether or not you should get the ZV-1 as your YouTube all-in-one studio camera: hit record and it does all the work for you. And that's actually what you get out of this. Regardless of the little drawbacks and the negatives that I mentioned, the video quality is fantastic and you don't have to do any of the work. You simply set it on auto, hit record, your videos will come out brilliantly. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you found this informative. Thank you so much for watching and making it all the way to the end of this video. New videos coming soon, and I'm the Revenge's Hammer.